Laudator Jesus Christus, and welcome to this live-streamed broadcast of Pope Francis's general audience for Wednesday, February 16th, 2022. My name is Christopher Wells.
And I'm Francesca Merlo, and we'll be providing the English commentary for today's audience. Whether you're joining us through various Vatican media channels, the Vatican audio or radio app, the Vatican News web portal or YouTube channel, or via one of our partner stations, including Radio Maria in Papua New Guinea, Radio Maria England, Catholic Faith Network in America, Shalom World TV, Salt and Light TV, Atmadarshan TV, EWTN TV, Catholic TV or Luminous Radio in India, a very warm welcome to one and all.
Pace sia con voi.
And the Holy Father is open to the audience with the sign of the cross and the liturgical greeting. We'll now hear the reading chosen for today's audience, which is taken from the Gospel of St. Matthew, chapter 2, verses 13 through 15, which describes the flight into Egypt. We're hearing the reading now in Italian. It will be repeated in the various languages, including English. In a moment, the Holy Father will be giving his catechesis for today, which he will pronounce in Italian, and for which we'll be providing an English translation.
Egli si alzò nella notte, prese con sé il bambino e sua madre, e si rifugiò in Egitto, dove rimase fino alla morte di Erode, perché si compisse ciò che era stato detto dal Signore per mezzo del profeta. Dall'Egitto ho chiamato mio figlio. Parola del Signore.
De l'Évangile selon Saint Matthieu. L'ange du Seigneur apparaît en songe à Joseph et lui dit « Lève-toi, prends l'enfant et sa mère et fuis en Égypte. Reste là-bas jusqu'à ce que je t'avertisse, car Hérode va rechercher l'enfant pour le faire périr. » Joseph se leva dans la nuit, il prit l'enfant et sa mère et se retira en Égypte, où il resta jusqu'à la mort d'Hérode, pour que soit accomplie la parole du Seigneur prononcée par le prophète. D'Égypte, j'ai appelé mon fils. Parole du Seigneur.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. An angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream and said, "Rise, take the child and his mother, and flee to Egypt, and remain there till I tell you. For Herod is about to search for the child to destroy him." And he rose and took the child and his mother by night and departed to Egypt, and remained there until the death of Herod. This was to fulfill what the Lord had spoken by the prophet. Out of Egypt have I called my son. The Gospel of the Lord.
Lesung aus dem Matthäusevangelium. Siehe, da erschien dem Josef im Traum ein Engel des Herrn und sagte, steh auf, nimm das Kind und seine Mutter und flieh nach Ägypten. Dort bleibe, bis ich dir etwas anderes auftrage. Denn Herodes wird das Kind suchen, um es zu töten. Da stand Josef auf und floh in der Nacht mit dem Kind und dessen Mutter nach Ägypten. Dort blieb er bis zum Tod des Herodes. Denn es sollte sich erfüllen, was der Herr durch den Propheten gesagt hat, aus Ägypten habe ich meinen Sohn gerufen. Wort des lebendigen Gottes.
Lectura del Evangelio según San Mateo. El ángel del Señor se apareció en sueños a José y le ordenó: Levántate, toma contigo al niño y a su madre y huye a Egipto. Quédate allí hasta que yo te diga, porque Herodes va a buscar al niño para matarlo. Él se levantó, tomó de noche al niño y a su madre y se fue a Egipto, donde estuvo hasta la muerte de Herodes, para que se cumpliera lo que dijo el Señor por medio del profeta. De Egipto llamé a mi hijo. Palabra del Señor.
Leitura do Evangelho de São Mateus. O anjo do Senhor apareceu em sonhos a José e disse-lhe: Levanta-te, toma o menino e sua mãe, foge para o Egito e fica lá até que eu te avise, pois Herodes procurará o menino para o matar. E ele levantou-se de noite, tomou o menino e sua mãe e partiu para o Egito, permanecendo ali até à morte de Herodes. Assim se cumpriu o que o Senhor anunciou pelo profeta: Do Egito chamei o meu filho. Palavra da salvação.
من إنجيل ربنا يسوع المسيح القديس متى تراءى ملك ربي ليوسف في الحلم وقال له قم فخذ الطفل وأمه واهرب إلى مصر وأقم هناك حتى أعلمك لأن هيرودس سيبحث عن الطفل ليهلكه فقام فأخذ الطفل وأمه ليلا ولجأ إلى مصر فأقام هناك إلى وفاة هيرودس ليتم ما قال الرب على لسان النبي من مصر دعوت ابني كلام الرب.
And having heard the scriptural reading for today, in a moment the Holy Father will be giving his catechesis.
Ewangelii według świętego Mateusza. W owym czasie anioł pański ukazał się Józefowi we śnie.
And we will be providing the English language for that catechesis.
I uchodź do Egiptu. Pozostań tam, aż ci powiem, bo Herod będzie szukał dziecięcia, aby je zgładzić. On wstał, wziął w nocy dziecię i jego matkę i udał się do Egiptu. Tam pozostał aż do śmierci Heroda. Tak miało się spełnić słowo, które Pan powiedział przez proroka: Z Egiptu wezwałem syna mego. Oto słowo Pańskie.
And now the Pope's catechesis.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno.
Dear brothers and sisters, good morning.
Concludiamo oggi il ciclo di catechesi sulla
Today we conclude the cycle of catechesis on the figure of Saint Joseph. These catechesis are complementary to the apostolic letter Patris Cordae, written on the occasion of the 150th anniversary of the proclamation of Saint Joseph as patron of the Catholic Church by Blessed Pius IX. But what does this title mean? What does it mean that Saint Joseph is patron of the Church? I would like to reflect upon this with you. In this case too, the Gospels provide us with the most correct key to interpretation. In fact, at the end of every story in which Joseph is the protagonist, the Gospel notes that he takes the child and his mother with him, and does what God has ordered him to do. Thus, the fact that Joseph's task is to protect Jesus and Mary stands out. He is their principal guardian. Indeed, Jesus and Mary, his mother, are the most precious treasure of our faith. In the plan of salvation, the son cannot be separated from the mother, from the one who advanced in the pilgrimage of faith and faithfully preserved her union with her son even to the cross, as the Second Vatican Council reminds us. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph are, in a sense, the primordial nucleus of the Church. And we too must always ask ourselves whether we are protecting Jesus and Mary with all our strength, who are mysteriously entrusted to our responsibility, our care, and our custody. The Holy Father is highlighting the importance of custody. The Christian is like Saint Joseph in a way, he says. It is not only maintaining the faith, but keeping custody of life. The Son of the Most High came into the world in a condition of great weakness. He wanted to be defended, protected, cared for. God trusted Joseph, as did Mary, who found in him the bridegroom who loved and respected her and always took care of her and the child. In this sense, Saint Joseph cannot be the custodian of the Church, because the Church is the extension of the body of Christ in history. And at the same time, in the maternity of the Church, the maternity of Mary is overshadowed. Joseph, in continuing to protect the Church, continues to protect the child and his mother, and we too, in loving the Church, continue to love the child and his mother. This child is the one who will say, "Whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers of mine, you did for me." Therefore, every person who is hungry and thirsty, every stranger, every person without clothes, every sick person, every prisoner is the child whom Joseph looks after. That is why he is invoked as protector of all the needy, the exiled, the afflicted, and even the dying. We spoke about this last Wednesday. And we too must learn from Joseph to safeguard these goods, to love the child and his mother, to love the sacraments and the people of God, to love the poor and our parish. Each of these realities is always the child and his mother. We live in a time in which it is common to criticize the Church, to point out its inconsistencies, its sins, which in reality are our inconsistencies and our sins, because the Church has always been a people of sinners who encounter God's mercy. Let us ask ourselves if in our hearts we love the Church.
Con tanti limiti, ma con tanta voglia di servire e amare Dio. Infatti, solo l'amore.
In fact, only love makes us capable of speaking the truth fully, in a non-partisan way, of saying what is wrong, but also of recognizing all the goodness and holiness that are present in her, starting precisely with Jesus and Mary.
camminare con la Chiesa.
Love the church, walk with the church.
Quel gruppetto che è vicino al prete e comanda tutti. No, la Chiesa siamo tutti, tutti.
We are all church.
Custodirci uno l'altro. Custodirsi a vicenda.
Taking care of one another, taking care of each other.
Una domanda questa. Io quando ho un problema con qualcuno, io cerco di custodirlo.
The Holy Father is saying that when he has a problem with someone, perhaps, he works to look after them and not condemn them. Dear brothers and sisters, I encourage you to ask for the intercession of Saint Joseph precisely at the most difficult times in the life of you and of your communities. Where our mistakes become a scandal, let us ask Saint Joseph to give us the courage to speak the truth, ask for forgiveness, and humbly begin again. Where persecution prevents the gospel from being proclaimed, let us ask Saint Joseph for the strength and patience to endure abuse and suffering for the sake of the gospel. Where material and human resources are scarce and make us experience poverty, especially when we are called to serve the last, the defenseless, the orphans, the sick, the rejected of society, let us pray to Saint Joseph to be providence for us. How many saints have turned to him? How many people in the history of the Church have found in him a patron, a guardian, a father? Let us imitate their example. And for this reason today, all together, let us pray to Saint Joseph with the prayer that I have placed at the conclusion of the letter Patris Corde, entrusting to him our intentions and in a special way the Church that suffers and is in trial. The Holy Father is inviting everyone to join in this prayer following the text. He's waiting for everyone to find the text, which should be made available to them.
Salve, custode del Redentore.
Hail, guardian of the Redeemer, spouse of the Blessed Virgin Mary. To you God entrusted his only Son. In you Mary placed her trust. With you Christ became man. Blessed Joseph, to us too, show yourself a father and guide us in the path of life. Obtain for us grace, mercy and courage, and defend us from every evil. Amen.
And that was the Holy Father's catechesis for today. In a short while, we'll have the text of that prayer available for you on our website. Following the catechesis, the Holy Father will greet the faithful and pilgrims of the various languages. Right now we hear the French speaker greeting the Holy Father in their name. The various speakers give a brief instruction, and then we'll read a short summary of the Holy Father's catechesis. As the summary in each of the various languages is effectively the same, we do not provide a translation for that. However, after the summary, the Holy Father will say a few words to each of the language groups in Italian, which will be then translated into their own languages. And after the Holy Father's greetings, we will provide a translation of each of those remarks.
Nous achevons aujourd'hui le cycle de nos catéchèses sur la figure de Saint Joseph, patron de l'Église catholique. Les évangiles nous rapportent que Joseph est le véritable gardien de Jésus et de Marie, avec qui il forme le noyau primordial de l'Église. C'est pourquoi il est encore aujourd'hui le protecteur de l'Église, car elle est le prolongement du corps du Christ dans l'histoire. Nous devons apprendre de Joseph à protéger, à aimer nous aussi, l'enfant Jésus et sa mère, c'est-à-dire
à aimer les sacrements et le peuple de Dieu, à aimer les pauvres et notre paroisse. Nous vivons une époque où il est commun de critiquer l'Église. Mais demandons-nous si du fond du cœur, nous aimons l'Église. En effet, seul l'amour nous rend capables de dire pleinement la vérité, de dire ce qui ne va pas, mais aussi de reconnaître tout le bien et la sainteté qui sont dans l'Église. Chers frères et sœurs, demandons l'intercession de Saint Joseph dans les moments les plus difficiles de notre vie et de celle de nos communautés, afin d'avoir le courage de demander pardon et de recommencer humblement, la force et la patience de savoir supporter les injustices et les souffrances par amour de l'Évangile. Que Saint Joseph soit notre providence. Et maintenant, Sa Sainteté va saluer en italien les francophones.
Saluto cordialmente le persone di lingua francese, particolarmente i giovani di Sundgau, i pellegrini di Lorient, quelli di Marsiglia e i sacerdoti dell'ordinariato degli orientali in Francia. Chiediamo la grazia di non chiudere gli occhi e le mani di fronte alla miseria dei nostri fratelli e sorelle. Sull'esempio di San Giuseppe sappiamo scoprire i volti di Gesù e di Maria che implorano il nostro amore, la nostra tenerezza, la nostra protezione. Dio vi benedica.
Vous saluant en italien, le Saint-Père vient de dire: Je salue cordialement les personnes.
I cordially greet the French-speaking people, especially the young people of Sundgau, the pilgrims of Lorient, and the priests of the Ordinariate of the Orientals of France. Let us ask for the grace not to close our eyes and hands to the misery of our brothers and sisters. Following the example of Saint Joseph, may we discover in them the faces of Jesus and Mary, who implore our love, tenderness, and protection. God bless you.
Now we will hear the greetings in English.
Most Holy Father, the English-speaking visitors and pilgrims present today wish to express to you their sentiments of respect and esteem, and to assure you of their prayers for your ministry as the successor of Pope Peter. At the end of the audience, we will sing together the Our Father in Latin. The Holy Father will then impart his apostolic blessing, which he willingly extends to all children and young people, to the elderly and the sick. His Holiness also intends to bless any religious articles you may have brought for this purpose. The following is a summary of the Holy Father's words this morning. Dear brothers and sisters, our catechesis on Saint Joseph now concludes with a reflection on his role as patron of the Universal Church. This title, bestowed on Saint Joseph 150 years ago by Blessed Pius IX, is based on the witness of Scripture. In the Gospels, Joseph is constantly presented as the guardian of the Virgin Mary and the child Jesus. Just as Joseph protected the Holy Family, so too he continues to love and protect the body of Christ, which is the Church, as well as the poor, the sick, and the dying, whom the Lord calls the least of his brothers and sisters. Saint Joseph teaches us that we too must love and protect the Church and Christ's poor. At a time when it is easy to criticize the Church, this means frankly acknowledging that we are a people of sinners graciously redeemed by God's mercy, while at the same time bearing witness to the risen Christ's presence in our midst, the transformative power of his grace in the sacraments, and the holiness which is the unfailing gift of the Spirit. Together with so many saints throughout history, let us commend ourselves and the needs of the Church to the protection of Saint Joseph, asking him, in the words of today's prayer, to guide us in the path of life and defend us from every evil. Amen. The Holy Father will now greet the English-speaking faithful in Italian.
Saluto i pellegrini di lingua inglese presenti all'udienza odierna. Su tutti voi e sulle vostre famiglie invoco la gioia e la pace del Signore. Dio vi benedica.
I greet the English-speaking pilgrims and visitors taking part in today's audience, especially those from the United States of America. Upon all of you and your families, I invoke the Lord's blessings of joy and peace. God bless you.
Following the English greetings, we have the greetings in German.
Heiliger Vater, die Gläubigen deutscher Sprache bekunden Ihnen, dem Nachfolger des heiligen Petrus, aufrichtige Verbundenheit, Dankbarkeit und Verehrung. Sie versichern Sie zugleich Ihres besonderen Gebetsgedenkens für Ihren apostolischen Dienst als Hirte der universalen Kirche. Zum Schluss dieser Audienz singen wir gemeinsam das Vaterunser in lateinischer Sprache. Danach wird der Heilige Vater allen den apostolischen Segen erteilen. Gern schließt er darin ihre Angehörigen ein, besonders die Kranken, die Kinder und die älteren Menschen. Zugleich segnet er auch die Rosenkränze und die übrigen Andachtsgegenstände, die Sie dafür mitgebracht haben. Es folgt nun eine Zusammenfassung der Katechese des Heiligen Vaters in deutscher Sprache. Liebe Brüder und Schwestern, zum Abschluss der Katechese-Reihe über den heiligen Josef betrachten wir ihn als Schutzpatron der Kirche, zu dem ihn der selige Pius IX. Erhoben hat. Die Evangelien erschließen uns die Bedeutung dieser Anrufung. Jede Begebenheit, in der der heilige Josef auftritt, endet mit der Bemerkung, dass er das Kind und seine Mutter zu sich nimmt und das tut, was Gott ihm geboten hat. Er tut das, was auch von uns erwartet wird, Jesus und Maria, den kostbarsten Schatz unseres Glaubens zu lieben und zu behüten. Josef erfüllt den Auftrag Gottes. Der Sohn Gottes wollte aus der Jungfrau Maria als wehrloses Geschöpf in diese Welt kommen und hat Josef als Beschützer erwählt. Daher ist es folgerichtig, dass er auch die Kirche behütet, die als mystischer Leib Christi in der Geschichte wirkt und als Mutter aller Getauften die Mutterschaft Marias widerspiegelt. So schützt Josef das Kind und seine Mutter auch heute noch. Lernen wir von Josef, Jesus und Maria, die Kirche und ihre Sakramente sowie das Volk Gottes und die Notleidenden zu lieben.
Saluto cordialmente i fedeli di lingua tedesca. San Giuseppe ci protegga da tutti gli attacchi del maligno perché, in seno alla comunione della Chiesa, possiamo sempre restare fedeli nell'amore a Gesù e Maria.
Herzlich grüße ich die Gläubigen deutscher Sprache.
I cordially greet the German-speaking faithful. May Saint Joseph protect us from all the attacks of the evil one, so that in the bosom of the communion of the Church we may always remain faithful in our love for Jesus and Mary.
The Holy Father will now speak in Spanish and will provide the summary himself, as Spanish is his mother tongue, and I will provide a translation of the greetings after.
Santo Padre, los fieles de lengua española que participan en esta audiencia desean manifestarle cordialmente sus sentimientos de filial afecto que acompañan con fervientes oraciones por sus intenciones de pastor de toda la Iglesia. Al final de este encuentro se cantará el Padre Nuestro en latín. Después, el Santo Padre impartirá la bendición apostólica a todos, especialmente a los niños y a los ancianos, a los enfermos y a cuantos sufren. Bendice también los rosarios y objetos de devoción que los peregrinos llevan consigo.
Queridos hermanos y hermanas, para cerrar nuestra catequesis dedicada a San José, hoy la última, meditamos sobre el título de patrono de la Iglesia Universal, el cual manifiesta la misión que por encargo de Dios lleva adelante como intercesor y protector de todos los cristianos. En su Evangelio, San Mateo nos narra cómo Dios escogió a San José para ser custodio y padre amoroso del niño Jesús y para ser sostén de la Virgen Madre como esposo solícito. El patrocinio de San José sobre la Iglesia Universal se fundamenta en esas dos características, ya que en la Iglesia siguen presentes la frágil humanidad que el Hijo de Dios hizo suya naciendo en Belén y una maternidad que es reflejo de la maternidad de María. San José sigue viendo en nosotros al niño y a la madre. Su ejemplo nos impulsa a reconocer en todo rostro afligido, en toda persona desvalida que acude a la Iglesia, la presencia de Jesús, que al decirnos todo lo que hicieron con uno de estos, mis hermanos más pequeños conmigo lo hicieron, se identifica amorosamente con nuestros hermanos más pobres y sufrientes. Saludo cordialmente a los peregrinos.
I cordially greet the Spanish-speaking pilgrims. Let us go to the intercession of Saint Joseph.
Acudamos a la intercesión de San José.
Let us go to the intercession of Saint Joseph in the difficult moments of life, especially when our errors create scandal, that we may have the courage to face the truth, to ask for forgiveness, and to begin again. When persecution prevents the gospel from being proclaimed, that we may have the strength and patience to face difficulties. And when we lack material resources, that we may always trust in divine providence. May the Lord bless you, and thank you very much.
Santo Padre, os peregrinos da língua portuguesa presentes nesta audiência e quantos nos acompanham através dos meios de comunicação social, testemunham a vossa santidade sentimentos de gratidão e afeto filial, que acompanham com as suas orações pelas vossas intenções de pastor universal da Igreja.
And now we hear the summary and greetings in Portuguese.
Cantaremos o Pai Nosso em latim. Depois, o Santo Padre concederá a todos a bênção apostólica, com pensamento especial às crianças, aos idosos, aos doentes e atribulados. Abençoará também os terços e demais objetos de devoção que os peregrinos presentes tenham consigo. Leio agora resumo da catequese que o Papa Francisco acaba de propor. Concluímos hoje o ciclo de catequeses sobre a figura de São José, que são complementares da minha carta apostólica intitulada Com Coração de Pai, escrita pelos 150 anos da declaração do nosso santo como padroeiro da Igreja Católica. E que significa isto? De certo modo, o núcleo primordial da Igreja é formado por Jesus, Maria e José. Sabemos que o Filho do Altíssimo veio ao mundo em condições de grande fragilidade. Precisou de ser defendido, protegido, cuidado. Pois bem, o Pai do Céu fiou-se de José, como aliás fez Maria, que nele encontrou o esposo que a amou e respeitou e sempre cuidou dela e do menino. Neste sentido, São José não pode deixar de ser o guardião da Igreja, Porque a Igreja é o prolongamento do corpo de Cristo na história. E, ao mesmo tempo, na maternidade da Igreja, espelha-se a maternidade de Maria. José, continuando a proteger a Igreja, continua a proteger o menino e sua mãe. E também nós, amando a Igreja, continuamos a amar o menino e sua mãe. Este menino tornar-se-á homem adulto. Então ouvi-lo-emos dizer: sempre que fizestes isto a um destes meus irmãos mais pequeninos, a mim mesmo fizestes. Assim, cada faminto e sequioso, cada forasteiro e pessoa sem agasalho, cada doente e encarcerado, é o menino que José guarda. Por isso, o invocamos como protetor de todos os necessitados, exilados, aflitos e moribundos. E nós temos de aprender com ele a guardar estes bens, amar o menino e sua mãe, amar os sacramentos e o povo de Deus, amar os pobres e a nossa paróquia. Em todas e cada uma destas realidades, sempre encontramos o menino e sua mãe. Agora, o Santo Padre saúda em italiano os peregrinos e ouvintes de língua portuguesa.
Cari peregrini di lingua portoghese, vi saluto tutti e vi incoraggio a venerare San Giuseppe. In lui troverete l'uomo della presenza quotidiana, discreta, nascosta, nella compagnia di Gesù e della Vergine Maria. Invocate tutti e tre come intercessori, sostegno e guida dei momenti di difficoltà, affinché non si esaurisca mai l'olio della fede e della gioia che sgorga da una vita in comunione con Dio.
Eis a tradução das suas palavras. Queridos peregrinos,
dear Portuguese-speaking pilgrims, I greet you all and I encourage you to venerate Saint Joseph. In him you will find the man of daily presence, discreet and hidden, in the company of Jesus and the Virgin Mary. Call upon all three as intercessors, as supports, and as guides in moments of difficulty, so that the oil of faith and joy, which flows from a life in communion with God, may never run out.
أيها الأب الأقدس يسر المؤمنين الناطقين باللغة العربية الحاضرين هنا أن يعبروا لكم عن مشاعر الاحترام والتقدير وشكر من البنوي.
And we now hear the summary and the greetings in Arabic. إلى الله
من أجل قداستكم وخدمتكم كخليفة القديس بطرس. في نهاية هذه المقابلة سنرتل معا صلاة الأبانة باللغة اللاتينية. ثم سيمنح الأب الأقدس جميع الحاضرين البركة الرسولية ويشمل بها جميع أحبائكم وخاصة الأطفال والمتزوجين حديثاً والمسنين والمرضى والمتألمين بألام شديدة وسيبارك كذلك المسابحة والأشياء الطقوية التي يحملها معه كل واحد منكم إليكم ملخص التعليم المسيحي لقداسة البابا فرانسيس اختتم قداسة البابا اليوم سلسلة التعليم المسيحي في القديس يوسف وتكلم على القديس يوسف شفيع الكنيسة الجامعة وقال كانت مهمة يوسف أن يحمي يسوع ومريم أمه كان حارساً لهما وهما أثمن كنز في إيماننا جاء يسوع للعالم ضعيفاً يحتاج إلى من يدافع عنه ويحميه ويعتني به فاختار الله لذلك يوسف ومريم أيضا وضعت ثقتها فيه فوجدت فيه الزوج الذي أحبها واحترمها وكان دائما يعتني بها وبابنها يسوع لهذا أصبح القديس يوسف حارسا للكنيسة أيضا لأنها هي امتداد لجسد المسيح في التاريخ وقال قداسته كل إنسان جائع وعطشان وغريب وبلا ملبس ومريض وسجين هو مثل الطفل الذي كان يحرسه يوسف ولهذا أصبح يوسف أيضا محاميا لكل المحتاجين والمنفيين والمحزونين. ومن هنا علينا نحن أيضا أن نتعلم منه أن نحافظ في حياتنا على محبة الطفل وأمه ومحبة الأسرار المقدسة وشعب الله ومحبة الفقراء ورعيتنا. واختتم قداسة البابا تعليمه وقال: أشجعكم على أن تطلبوا شفاعة القديس يوسف في أصعب لحظات حياتكم، فهو الشفيع والحارس والأب الأمين لكل واحد منا. والآن تحية البابا باللغة الإيطالية لأبناء الشرق الناطقين اللغة العربية.
Saluto i fedeli di lingua araba. San Giuseppe è il patrono, il custode, il padre che si alzò nella notte, prese con sé il bambino e Maria, sua madre, e si rifugiò in Egitto per fuggire da Erode. Chiediamo a lui di guidarci nel cammino della vita e difenderci da ogni male. Signore, vi benedica tutti.
أحيي المؤمنين الناطقين باللغة العربية.
I greet the Arabic-speaking faithful. Saint Joseph is the patron, guardian, and father who rose in the night, took the child and Mary, his mother, with him and fled to Egypt to escape Herod. Let us ask him to guide us on the path of life and defend us from all evil. May the Lord bless you all.
Ojcze Święty, pielgrzymi z Polski i z innych krajów obecni na tej audiencji pragną złożyć Waszej świątobliwości najserdeczniejsze wyrazy czci i oddania oraz zapewnić o swojej gorącej modlitwie we wszystkich intencjach.
And now we hear the summary and greetings in Polish.
Na zakończenie audiencji zaśpiewamy wspólnie modlitwę nasz po łacinie. Następnie Ojciec Święty udzieli apostolskiego błogosławieństwa wszystkim tu obecnym, obejmując nim również nasze rodziny, dzieci, młodzież, a szczególnie osoby w podeszłym wieku i dotknięte cierpieniem. Pobłogosławi także różańce i inne dewocjonalia, jakie pielgrzymi przynieśli ze sobą. Oto istotne myśli z katechezy Ojca Świętego. Drodzy bracia i siostry, dzisiaj kończymy cykl kateches poświęconych postaci świętego Józefa. Są one uzupełnieniem listu apostolskiego Patris Corde, napisanego z okazji 150. rocznicy ogłoszenia świętego Józefa patronem Kościoła katolickiego przez błogosławionego Piusa IX. Ewangelie podkreślają, że święty Józef czyni zawsze to, co Bóg mu nakazuje. Jego zadaniem jest chronienie Jezusa i Maryi. Jest ich opiekunem. Istotnie, Jezus i Maryja są najcenniejszym skarbem naszej wiary. Każdy z nas powinien zadać sobie pytanie, czy w moim życiu troszczę się o dziecię Jezus i Jego Matkę ze wszystkich sił, jak święty Józef, opiekun Kościoła? Tym dziecięciem jest bowiem dzisiaj każdy głodny, spragniony, bezdomny, uchodźca, chory, więzień, potrzebujący, strapiony, umierający. Uczmy się od świętego Józefa, jak miłować ubogich, potrzebujących pomocy, jak troszczyć się o nasze rodziny, parafię. Żyjąc w czasach, w których powszechna jest krytyka Kościoła, zapytajmy, czy kochamy Kościół, czy jesteśmy obiektywni, bezstronni w ocenach zdarzeń, czy widzimy dobro i świętość Kościoła, czy postrzegamy raczej tylko grzech i zło. Wypraszajmy wstawiennictwo świętego Józefa w trudnych sprawach naszego życia. Niech on wyjedna nam odwagę mówienia prawdy, cierpliwość, umiejętność przebaczania i służenia braciom. Prosimy dzisiaj o to słowami modlitwy z listu Patris Corde. Święty Józefie, także i nam okaż się Ojcem i prowadź nas na drogach życia. Wyjednaj nam moc ducha i łaskę miłosierdzia i broń nas od wszelkiego zła. Amen. Obecnie Ojciec Święty pozdrowi nas, Polaków, w języku włoskim.
Saluto cordialmente i pellegrini polacchi. Lunedì. Lunedì abbiamo celebrato la memoria dei santi fratelli Cirillo e Metodio, monaco e Metodio, vescovo, apostoli delle Slavi e patroni d'Europa. Preghiamo Dio affinché per la loro intercessione le nazioni di questo continente, consapevoli delle loro radici cristiane, risveglino lo spirito di riconciliazione, di fraternità, di solidarietà e di rispetto di ogni paese e la libertà di ogni paese. Benedico di cuore voi tutti e i vostri cari.
Oto słowa Ojca Świętego.
I cordially greet the Polish-speaking pilgrims. On Monday, we celebrated the memory of our holy brothers, Saint Cyril, a monk, and Saint Methodius, bishop, apostles of the Slavs and patrons of Europe. Let us pray to God that through their intercession, the nations of this continent, aware of their Christian roots, may awaken the spirit of reconciliation, fraternity, solidarity, and peace. I cordially bless you and all your loved ones. And finally, after the Polish, we will hear the greetings in Italian, as the Holy Father gave the catechesis in Italian. There's no summary. And the Holy Father will read the greetings in Italian himself. Of course, we'll be providing a translation of his remarks.
A conclusione di questa udienza, canteremo la preghiera del Padre Nostro in latino, terminata la quale il Santo Padre impartirà la benedizione apostolica che estende a tutte le persone care, in modo speciale ai bambini, agli anziani, ai sofferenti. Benedirà anche i rosari e gli oggetti di devozione che ciascuno porta con sé.
Rivolgo un cordiale benvenuto ai pellegrini di lingua italiana.
I extend a cordial welcome to the Italian-speaking pilgrims. In particular, I greet the priests of Vicenza and the seminarians of Adria Rovigo. As I greet the religious of the Order of Clerics Regular Minor, I think of their young brother, Father Richard, of the Democratic Republic of the Congo, who was killed on the 2nd of February after celebrating Mass on the Day of Consecrated Life. May the death of Father Richard, victim of an unjustifiable and deplorable act of violence, not discourage his family, his religious family, and the entire Christian community of that nation from being heralds and witnesses of goodness and fraternity, despite the difficulties, imitating the example of Jesus, the Good Shepherd. Finally, as usual, my thoughts go to the elderly, the sick, the young, and newlyweds. In a world which continues to be torn apart by deep and apparently irreconcilable contrasts, may each one of you, for his or her part, be a sign of reconciliation, rooted in the word of the gospel. My blessing to you all.
And now the Holy Father will lead us in the Our Father in Latin, and we will receive his apostolic blessing.
Adveniat regnum tuum, pecoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem, sed libera nos a malo.
Domine hoviscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Sin nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc nunc et usque in saeculum.
Aeterium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui feci celum et terram.
Benedica vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, Filius, Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen. Amen.
And with the Holy Father's blessing, the general audience draws to a close. On behalf of Vatican Radio, I'd like to thank our partners who help make these live broadcasts available throughout the world, especially Radio Maria in Papua New Guinea, Radio Maria England, Catholic Faith Network in America, Shalom World TV, Salt and Light TV, Atmajashan TV, EWTN TV, Catholic TV, and Luminous Radio in India.
Thanks also to all of our producers and technicians here in studio who made this broadcast possible, and thanks to all of you for joining us this morning.
For full coverage of today's catechesis, along with other Vatican and world news, we invite you to visit the Vatican News web portal, as well as our Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube accounts. My name is Christopher Wells.
And I'm Francesca Merlo, and it has been a pleasure providing the English language translation of today's general audience.
And this concludes the live-streamed broadcast of Pope Francis' general audience of Wednesday, February 16th, 2022. Praise be Jesus Christ. Laudetur Jesus Christus.